Sajjad Basic from Krill in Lens, and Ravitomopoulos from INRIA in Montpellier. So today I'm going to present how to implement a broken Sajjad Basic next approach using argumentation. But first, I'm going to do a quick background. So argumentation in its simplest form consists of a set of arguments and a set of facts. So here you have an example of an argumentation graph, so it's a directed graph. And you can use argumentation semantics to extract subset of arguments that we call an extension, so they correspond to consistent viewpoints. And on the other hand, we have structured argumentation. So structured argumentation is using a language to express knowledge, and then we also specify how we can build arguments and facts from the knowledge. So the problematic of my thesis is how can you implement knowledge based with argumentation and existential rules. So suppose here that you have a subject here that is being observed by three agents. So agent one, we say, has great food. Agent two, we say, the subject is a cat. And agent three, we say, the agent is a chair. So here we say that the different agents have different observations about the subject, and then that we have inconsistency that emerge from these different observations. So we can use argumentation to build arguments, and then using the argumentation semantics, we can extract different consistent viewpoints. So the first one here at the left side is a cat with great fur, and at the right side is a chair. So if someone is asked to choose between these different viewpoints, that's not an easy task because he cannot choose which one is the correct one. So what we intend to do is to use ranking to say, oh, this consistent viewpoint is better than this one. So we have a lot of methods to do that. Okay, but I want to say that the problem is more complex than just saying counting the number of agents for each viewpoint. For example, you cannot just say, oh, we have two agents that offer this viewpoint, so this one is obviously better than this one, because we have to consider other parameters. For example, maybe what it is saying is more important than what the agent 3 is saying, or maybe we have also the ontology to consider. So just counting the number of agents for each viewpoint is not that simple. So this is the thesis at a glance, so we want to see the whole thing. Okay? So we begin with our subject and the agents. And what we are doing is that we build the inconsistent knowledge rate that corresponds to what to the saying that the agents are seeing. And then from that we build the argumentation graph. So we build arguments and the facts. Then we compute the viewpoint or the extension, and then we select the best viewpoint that we call the matrix. So here we have the first problem. So what is the language that we use to represent the inconsistent knowledge base here? So how do we build the argumentation graph? What is the argumentation framework that we use? Do we have tools to do that, to automatically compute the argumentation graph? So what is the look of the graph that we generated? Do we have particular structure on that? Can we improve the argumentation framework? So how do we compute the viewpoints? So we know that we have solvers, but which one is better on our graph? And how do we select the best viewpoints? And is it efficient? Is there a method to select the best viewpoint? So we provide some answers here. So first, we use the existential rules language because this is a language that is expressive enough and is widely used in the semantic webs, and also is efficient for query answering. We will use a specific argumentation framework, so it's a very simple argumentation framework with deductive arguments, so premise and conclusion. I won't go into the detail, but if you want, we can talk later. And we have also developed the direct we will show that we also have structural properties on the generative graph. We also have made some improvement to the argumentation framework without losing good properties. We also made a benchmark on the solvers, so we selected some solvers from a competition, and we used the best solvers and we benchmarked them on our generative graph, and we showed that one of the solvers performs extremely well on our graph. And lastly, we used a different framework to rank the viewpoints, and one of them is to use the ranking on arguments to lift it to have a ranking on exception. So basically my thesis can be split into three parts. So the first one is how to build argumentation graph from inconsistent knowledge base. The second one is what are the particularities of the generated graph, and how we can improve that to make it the generation faster and more efficient. And the last one is how to choose between the viewpoints. So, the Dagger tool is a tool that we developed to generate argumentation graph from an inconsistent knowledge base expressed using existential rules. So the input of this tool is a file in the NVP format. So this format is a format that is close to Prolog, but specific for existential rules. This tool can be used with the existing solvers because they export the graph in an aspect-x format. It is also possible to visualize the graph and to move the nodes to see it better in different angles. And we also have pretty other functions such as activating the minimality of the support or deactivating that, etc. So we have two papers on this tool. So the first one is a short paper in AMAT 2018 that presents the tool. And we have a paper in COMA 2018 to how to generate the benchmark using the tool. So this is the interface of the tool, so it's pretty simplistic. So the left part of the tool is where you write the knowledge base. In the middle part, you can select an option if you want to visualize, compute the reverse, have the minimality on premises on. And the right side, we have the answer, so the list of arguments and the list of attacks. And in the bottom part, you have the number of arguments, number of attacks, and time it took to generate the graph. We also have a video here where you can see how to use the tool. So now that we generated the graph, so we show that we have particular properties on the graph. First, it's cyclic, so you have a cipher inside. We know that if you are attacked, then you will be defended. We also have many other properties here. We know that this is very important because that possibly you have an exponential number of arguments with respect to the number of arguments. So this may be hard to use it in practice. So this is a big drawback for the argumentation graph. So we want to emphasize that because a lot of argumentation framework stay theoretical, and we wanted to show that in practice some are not really good. We showed that there are also repetitive patterns inside of the graph. So repetitive pattern appears because you have three facts. So there are facts that are not in any negative constraint. So this will make repetitive patterns. And also we make an analysis of strongly connected components in the case where you have no rules in the knowledge base. So there are two papers on that. So the short paper in AMS 2018 and a long version in the workshop GKR 2018. So this is the form of a graph that you can generate from an inconsistent knowledge base. So you can see that here you have repetitive patterns. These are repetitive patterns of these nodes. You can see also that there are symmetry in this graph. Okay. And you have simplicity here, right? So we wanted to improve the existing framework because we have an exponential number of arguments. And to answer that, we we added minimality, but also we saw the effect of course on our framework. So in this paper here, we try to use course after generating the framework to reduce the number of arguments. So in this paper, we use course that also show the effect on ranking semantics. We also analyze different types of attacks. So in this paper in ICCS 2018, we did try different kind of attacks and show that in an experiment in food packaging, some users prefer to use this kind of attacks instead of this kind of attacks. And in the last one, so we kept the general framework that we are using, and we try to create the argumentation graph faster. So in this paper, in COMA 2018, we separate two cases here. So if the knowledge base has no rules, we can make a process of this knowledge base before generating the graph. So this will make the generation faster. Or if we have rules, we can generate the arguments, make a filtration on the arguments, and then we can generate the graph using multi-pages. So the graph that we obtain have good properties such as equivalence with the original framework. So now that we have the annotation graph, we can also check into the generation of the extension or the viewpoints. So we usually use solvers to compute the extension. So in the ICCMA competition, there is a list of solvers, and they have overall ranking on the solvers using a border. And we use the top solvers of this competition, and we made a benchmark on these solvers on our graph. And we have a ranking of solvers that is different from the competition. And we have one solver that obtained from all the other solvers on our graph. So this is a paper where you can read more details about that. So a structural benchmark for logical argumentation framework. So this is the result of the benchmark. Right here you have the task that we ask the servers to do. So here you have, for example, find some of the extension, complete extension. Or here you have find all of the complete extension, for example. And for all those tasks, we give a ranking on the solvers here. And we see here that these solvers perform extremely well on all of these tasks. So we try to ask the developers of this solver why we have this ranking. And he told us that it was because our graph has a particular structure that is very structured. And then that his solver did perform well on really structured graph. So that may be the reason behind this ranking. And lastly, we wanted to investigate several ways of choosing the best extension of viewpoint. The first one is using preferences and argumentation. So on this paper, on 2016, we had a collection of packaging, and each packaging has several characteristics, and we asked like 800 consumers about their preferences on each of these characteristics, and we succeeded in making a ranking on the packaging. Then we, in this paper, we use the ranking of arguments that we obtained using ranking semantics, and we lifted it on ranking on extensions. So this paper will be presented in COMA 2018. And the last method that we use is to have a ranking on readers, so directly on the knowledge base that is based on inconsistency measure. So inconsistency measure give a ranking on the fact of the knowledge base. So this one does not use argumentation. But this one is interesting because in our argumentation framework we have a one-to-one equivalence between reapers and extensions. So this ranking on reapers can be exploited to have a ranking on viewpoints. So this paper is inconsistency measure for reaper semantics in OBDA, so each type they can 2018. So I would like to conclude. So my thesis from provided a tool for generating argumentation graph from inconsistent knowledge rate expressed in existential rules. We gave some structural properties for the generated graph. We also gave some efficient methods for generating the graph. A benchmark for argumentation solvers on the generated graph, and also so this was useful because now we know that one solver can be used for our generated graph. And the last one is a method for choosing the best viewpoint. So we investigate three methods and we plan to study which one is better if we have good properties. Thank you.